Howdy, howdy, howdy. I'm glad to be here. Hope you are too. I am doing the continuation of what I promised from yesterday on what if you got the all overs. You ever get the all overs? And you want to start vending. You want to start a hot dog cart or you want to start something and you go, man, I have no way to have the money to do that. I don't have the money. Simply am broke. I either work so much and everything I make is already, you know, allotted. It's going to take me years to save up. I don't have anything to sell. I don't have people I can borrow from. Can't get financing, whatever it is, right? It doesn't prevent you from starting. A few years ago, I started diving deep into this because as more and more people came along that wanted help, many of them were broke like me when I started. And I mean, literally I was on food stamps and a borrowed house and a borrowed car. So if you find yourself in that situation and you're going, okay, I just can't start. Well, I've already talked to you a little bit about kitcheninincome.com, which uses the cottage food laws. And so that's a great way to start, but maybe you don't want to start that way. Or maybe you want to actually go into business doing on the street vending or at little events or gigs. Well, there's several things. One is catering. Okay. And I'm going to tell you, that I have done extensive stuff on catering, extensive training on it, and you can get that stuff for free at learnhotdogs.com. And it doesn't mean you're catering hot dogs. It's just where my blog is, and I pigeonholed myself with the name of that blog a long time ago. So, but it covers everything. So if you go to learnhotdogs.com, there's a little search box, and you type in the word cater or catering, you're going to pull up all of that. And that will help you, you know, inspire you, and you go, oh, man, I could be catering. Right? Like my daughter did. Then you could go, okay, well, how can I do this without a cart? I need a cart to look professional. No, you don't. Okay, today I posted at our website on Facebook, not our website, but our Facebook page. I posted today a picture of Kate. Kate is one of the Vendors United members, and she has been doing this. She makes these meals, meal prep. And then now she's doing these catering jobs where she did a taco bar, I think three in the last week is what it's about. And it shows her taco bar setup. We've got people doing just like Kate that are kicking butt with this as a full-time income, but a part-time job. And so it's a way to get going without having the expense of a lot of equipment. Now I'm going to show you a website I created to help you with this. Okay, this will walk you through all the different opportunities that I'm going to talk about in getting started. Let me pull this up real quick. All right, so here it is. And the way to there is right up here at the top of the screen, starting without a hot dog cart or starting without anything. You can go to learnhotdogs.com/broke, okay? Because you may be broke, like I was, and I didn't have any way to do this. I didn't have a way, and I didn't know there was these other alternatives. I've learned these since, tested these since, had thousands and thousands of vendors get started this way. Some stayed in it. Some stayed where they were and are making great money. So Kate's got a cart now, but she's doing this because she makes so much freaking money with it. Plus, it's less time for her, and it gives her it gives her more access. She's a single mom. It gives her more free time, but it also allows her to limit when she's out and away from home. And it's cold, okay? So in the winter, it's great. This is her second winter doing this, and she kicks butt. And she shares this with us in the Vendors United group, and she shares her tips and tricks and helps many other vendors get going with it. So go to learnhotdogs.com/broke, and that will help you out. But let me show you this real quick. This is the page, and I may have to pull this up real quick and so that I can change this. Yeah. Okay. Now I got it. All right. So this is a setup I'm showing here on the screen of a vendor who started with just one griddle and then he went to two. He went to a cooktop and a griddle. And these are all simple, cheap, or inexpensive things to buy. And you can go to a used restaurant supply. You can oftentimes find them on Facebook Marketplace and buy local because this is not commercial equipment. And so, which I want to tackle that real quick. You may get an inspector, a health inspector that goes, hey, you need to have commercial equipment. There is no such thing. There is no governing body in the country that deems something commercial or not. The only person that deems it is the manufacturer. So I manufacture hot dog carts, right, and food trailers. I can just put a label on it, commercial. It's now commercial. I could put a sticky note on it that says commercial. It's now commercial. There's no governing body for that. So never let them get you wrapped up in that crap. So I could be making these, my little vape things, and go, oh, it's a commercial vape pen. You see what I'm saying? So I'm sorry to sidetrack you there, but anyway, that is how one vendor did it right there. And then I go through all the tips and tricks about affording a cart and what you can do to get around that, and actually how you can even start working with a cart without money. I share that with you as well in here. I talk about a magic button, and it's kind of sarcastic. We had a lady, and we actually featured her, and she was in our Vendors United group, and she was awesome. She was on a dirt road, but it was a highly trafficked dirt road. She set up a table and crock pots and did hot dogs. Okay. Her name was Cheryl Fortuna. And if you look at this first, it's the slow cooker method. And then we've got Jennifer in Phoenix, did an interview with her on here. Chef Jose, and his lemonade, three days, four grand with a manual press. Okay. Anyway, I've got videos for you. I've got pictures of like Cheryl set up and then other people. And then I've got, crowdfunding. I talk about how to get help with crowdfunding and how the right way to do it. I get a lot of emails from people that go, but you know, I tried to put me a GoFundMe page up and I got $10 or I got $17 or whatever. Doing it right makes a lot of difference. A lot of people just think they're going to put it up and money's going to just start appearing. That's not how it works. Only if you're really, really lucky. And if you're that lucky, you need to be playing the lottery. Okay. So I talk about that in here. I talk about the cottage food industry, which I brought up at the beginning, and that is kitcheninincome.com. Okay. Go there and it gives you a multitude of ideas, a myriad of ideas. There's another word that says that, but some people don't like the other word that means myriad. So then you have shoestring budget. So you can start on a shoestring budget. You can build a hot dog cart. Okay, I talked about that yesterday, but maybe you don't have $1,200, $1,300 to build a cart, right? So I have alternatives for that. Faster, cheaper, better. I've got this. This is what I love. This is what I showed you in the first picture right up here at the top. Okay, look there. See that? You can go cheaper than that setup. I'm talking just a couple $100 and be vending, legally vending. Because your health inspector can't say, oh, it's got to be on a cart. Show me the rule. Show me the rule. If you ever hear something stupid from an inspector that just sounds idiotic, go to learnhotdogs.com/liar. I give you the ammunition so that you can counter that in a diplomatic way, diplomacy, right? And overcome those hurdles. So let me go back down here real quick. So that's that burner unit. You can get that off of Amazon, dirt cheap, right? You can go look at this, over 800 hot dogs without a cart. This is real people doing this. Okay, that's that whole story and link to it. This is all your supplies to set up like he did, but even cheaper. Okay. I've got instant vending so that you can do that. I've got so much stuff here for you, and it may overwhelm your brain, but something's going to resonate with you. You know, it's like looking at a menu and you go, what am I going to eat? And you go down it, there's a lot of options, but there may be two on there that you go, I'm definitely having one of these, right? Well, that's kind of what I've done here with this article. I've made it a menu to go, okay, I don't really want to start with lemonade and a hand smasher, or I don't really want to go work for another vendor or use his cart when he's not using it, which is a great way, by the way, okay? And I share that in here and how other people have started that way. And then, because a vendor's not using his cart every day, none of them are. So you use it on the days they're not, okay? So, this single mom, phenomenal. I did an interview with her. Look at her crock pot. Okay. There's her whole setup. There's so many of these, and you'll just go, and then got a cart. Okay. Anyway, and her $1 million goal. There's so much stuff that you can do to make this happen for you. Now, is it a little bit more tricky and it doesn't feel as professional? You remember yesterday I said there's psychological things that happen with us where we go, I don't want to start with a used cart, or I don't want to start with a table and burners and pans. Why not? Why not? Go to Kate's page today, and look at what she's doing. She has a cart. She makes plenty of money now. 3 years ago, 4 years ago, she took her family flew her whole freaking family to the beach for extended family, everybody, and rented a big castle-like thing, huge house, okay, on the beach, and let people just enjoy life. And she did that because she does hot dogs. She was a Dollar General manager before. Okay, I think a district manager or a regional manager or something like that. Working 900 hours a week, never getting to see her daughter, no free time. She changed it all. And she didn't say no. She didn't go, well, my town's too small. There ain't enough red lights here. You know, you heard me talk the other day. I said the in Globe, Arizona, they talk about, you know, people talk about my town's too small. The best place to go is small towns, period. If you live in a big town, go find you a small community. You'll do better. I guarantee it. Every time. Every single time. Jason Brown lived near Pittsburgh or something, one of the Pennsylvania big cities, and he vended in a little bitty city because people freaking loved it. And so that's the difference. So don't let your preconceived notions and crap change what you do or change your potential for success, because I promise you, if you just do this a little while, maybe your goal is a $300,000 food truck with them fancy blue windows that pop up on the top like Jason Brown eventually got. That may be your goal. Great. You got to make steps to get there, right? And it's better not to go get a $300,000 loan and than it is to just let your first business pay for it. It will pay for it fast. Depending on what you want to put into it, you can get there fast. Or you may go, you know what, I got a 3-year plan. I'm going to work it. I'm going to do exactly what Ben says to do. I'm going to join Vendors United. I'm going to get advice from the top vendors in the freaking world. And I'm going to do this. That's all you have to do. And you will be successful. No ifs, ands, or buts. There is no risk involved. If you do the steps, you will make money. And I know I preach that all the time, but it is so true. I watch it every single day. So I want you to go. If you're struggling and need a way to start without money, no money, learnhotdogs.com/broke. I give you a multitude of ideas for starting that have been tried, tested, and are still being done daily that you can start and go, okay, I can go with this one off the menu. I want this. I want the ribeye, and I want this with it, and I'm going to do it. And you can go do it. And so there's so many things I would have done different had I known this information then. It's invaluable to me, the information now that I'm able to share it. It's why I do this. I make plenty of money selling hot dog carts, okay? I'm not a millionaire, but I can go fishing anytime I want. But I do this because I feel morally obligated to you to share what I learn. And because I'm in Vendors United, I learn stuff daily from other vendors. It's not like I have all the experience and I'm the world's wealth of knowledge. No, not even close. I'm a dumbass. But I learn and pick up stuff and then I deliver it because I go, oh my gosh, what a great idea. And it just gets better and better. So you can change everything you want. You can turn around and be your own boss. Own your life, own your time, own your freedom. And have more money coming in than you would at a job, a J-O-B. I think job is just over broke. It's just over broke. Because we typically spend what we make, and we ain't going to make more than they're paying us. There's no room for improvement unless you're like a commissioned salesperson. And then you could make a little bit more, right? You could make a little bit more, and you could boost it up and boost it up. But then you have a bad month or whatever. This is just, it just gets better. You keep doing it, it just gets better. It doesn't get worse. So, you know, used to vendors were all worried that, oh, in the winter it slows down. Well, kinda. But then you also have people like Kate who are out there doing to-go meals, delivery meals, you know, where they pick up these meals she's made and created for them. Now she's doing the healthy meals like I mentioned the other day. And you can go follow her, okay? You can join Vendors United. She'll help you. You can ask her questions. She'll go, hey, you need to do this, this, and this. And she's a badass. She will tell you the truth. She will speak plainly to you. And she'll go, look, Rob or Bob or Jenny or whoever, look, you got to do this and this, and then you're done. And it just grows and grows. So don't think that because you don't have a pocket full of cash or a bank full of money that you can't go start this today. You can start one of the kitchen income things today, kitcheninincome.com. You can start one today and be making money today. Today. I love you. I hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks for listening to me. I hope it helps you. I hope it inspires you. And please reach out to me and share your story as you start to change things. And if you don't think this is happening to people, go to the Facebook page. Go right here on YouTube even and look at the comments. Look at what this does for vendors and people that want to change their lives. I love you. Bye.